Hello children, today we are going to discuss some of the important questions on the chapter The Third Level written by Jack Finney. Answer each of the following questions in about 30 to 40 words. Question number one. What does the third level refer to? What is the significance of the third level? Answer for the first question. The third level is a medium of escape through which man yearns to be away from life's harsh realities. Modern life is devoid of peace and tranquility, so man in his quest to seek solace escapes to a place where his aim is to seek the realization of his dreams and unfulfilled wishes of his subconscious mind. Question number two. What convinced Charlie that he had reached the third level at Grand Central Station and not the second level? Answer for the second question. The general layout of the third level was different from that of the second level. It had comparatively smaller rooms, fewer ticket windows, and lesser train gates. The information booth in the center was made of wood and looked old. The place with its brass spittoons did not look very bright, so Charlie was convinced it was not the second level. Question number three. How does Charlie, the narrator, describes the third level at Grand Central Station? Answer for the question number three. Charlie says that the rooms on the third level were smaller than that of the second level. There were fewer ticket windows and train gates, and the information booth in the center was wood and old looking. There were open flame gas lights and brass spittoons on the floor. Everyone at the station was dressed in the 19th century dresses. Question number four. How did Charlie make sure that he was not in the present time? Answer for the question number four. To make sure that he was not in the present time, Charlie did a reality check. He looked at the newspapers which were on sale at a kiosk and found a copy of the newspaper The World, which carried the main story on President Cleveland. Then he confirmed from the public library files that the newspaper he had seen was dated 11 June 1894. Question number five. How did Charlie often get lost on the Grand Central Station? Answer for the question number five. The Grand Central Station was growing like a tree, pushing out endless corridors, doorways, and stairs like roots. It had intricate and tangled pathways. The network of passages was so complicated that instead of reaching its destination, one did tend to move up and down to look for entries and exits. So Charlie often got lost on this station. Question number six. Why did Charlie suspect that Sam had gone to Galesburg? Answer for the question number six. When Sam disappeared all of a sudden and no one knew about his whereabouts, Charlie suspected He had gone to Galesburg as Sam was a city boy and liked Galesburg very much. Then Charlie found an envelope mailed to Sam by his grandfather from his home in Galesburg, and so it confirmed that Sam was indeed in Galesburg. Question number 7. How does Charlie describe Galesburg as it used to be in 1894? Answer for the question number 7. Charlie describes Galesburg as a quiet, simple and peaceful place with big old frame houses, huge lawns and tremendous trees. The summer evenings were rather long and people sat out on their lawns in a peaceful world, men smoking cigars and women waving palm leaf fans. Question number 2. What convinced Charlie that he had reached the third level at Grand Central Station and not? Answer for the first question. The third level is a medium of escape through which man yearns to be away from life's harsh realities. Modern life is devoid of peace and tranquility, so man in his quest to seek solace escapes to a... Answer for the second question. The general layout of the third level was different from that of the second level. It has... Answer for the question number 9. Sam was fascinated by Charlie's description of Galesburg. He was so burdened by the tensions and stress of modern life that he thought of escaping to the peaceful world of Galesburg. His advice to Charlie is that he and his wife, Louisa, should come over to Galesburg through the medium of the third level. Question number 10. Why did the booking clerk refuse to accept the money? Answer for the question number 10. The booking clerk refuses to accept the money because the notes Charlie had given him were of old style. He did not pay in the currency notes that were in circulation in 1894. So the clerk stared at him and told him, "That ain't money, mister." He thought Charlie was trying to cheat him and even threatened to get him arrested. Question number 11. Why did Charlie rush back from the third level? Answer for the question number 11. When Charlie took out the modern currency to pay for the two tickets to Galesburg, the ticket clerk accused him of trying to cheat him. He threatened to hand Charlie over to the police. Charlie was frightened and he decided to rush back from the third level lest he was arrested and put into prison. Question number 12. How did Charlie reach the third level of Grand Central? How was it different from the other levels? Question number 4. How did Charlie make sure that he was not in the present time? Question number one. What does the third level refer to? Answer for question number 13. The fears, anxieties, and insecurities of the modern world are taking a toll on man's mind. He feels helpless and frustrated and seeks temporary respite from life's harsh realities. Charlie too was unable to cope up with his fast-paced and stressful life, so his flight to the third level was undoubtedly a medium of escape for him. It is nothing but a creation of Charlie's own mind. He wants to escape from the modern world's insecurity, fear, worries, and stress, and so seeks an exit, a medium to get away into the world of dreams and fancies. Question number 7. How does Charlie describe Galesburg as it used to be? Answer for the question number 14. One night Charlie worked late at the office. He was in a hurry to get to his apartment, so he decided to take the subway from Grand Central. He ducked into an arched doorway and then he got lost. He walked down the steps to the second level, turned left and kept on walking. He came out on the third level at the Grand Central Station. This was a different, old and romantic world. So he was convinced that he was actually standing at the third level. There were fewer ticket windows there which were made of wood and were old looking. There were open flame gas lights. He saw people with beards, sideburns and fancy mustaches. Then he caught a glimpse of an old locomotive and also saw an 1894 issue of the World newspaper. Perhaps Charlie is under pressure to escape from the harsh world of realities. He would like to escape to the peaceful world of 1894.